From the University of South Carolina, your news, your sports, your weather. Carolina News begins now.
Hello and welcome to the last web show for Carolina News of the semester. I'm Emily Riley. The Pastides Christmas tree lighting took place last night on the Horseshoe, reminding us Christmas and Christmas break are just around the corner. Members of the USC Women's Club were at the President's House yesterday decorating for the festive night with USC's First Lady. Mrs. Pastides said the women are not the only ones getting in the holiday spirit.
Harris is kind of a character, so he's been writing the lyrics to his own lyrics to the 12 Days of Christmas.
The tree will be lit every night on the Horseshoe until Christmas, and Mrs. Pastides welcomes everyone to come look at the holiday decor. And along with tree lighting, Santa Claus came to town last night. St. Nick was on Main Street at the Mass General Store. He took photos with shoppers and brought festivity and holiday spirit to the store. And Santa stayed in town for the Toys for Tots parking lot party today. The event, hosted by All Seasons Healthcare, had people from all over Columbia socializing and giving back by donating toys. The drive featured many special guests like USC cheerleaders, former USC running back Marcus Lattimore, the Marines, and of course, Santa himself. And Santa Claus happens to get a lot of pet requests, and with the holidays coming up, pet adoption rates are increasing. And the workers at Palmetto Lifeline want you to remember the responsibility of having a pet before making that lifelong commitment. The ASPCA says that owning a pet can cost at least $1,000. So if you're thinking of adopting a pet this holiday season, make sure you are prepared for your furry family member. Well, the holiday season does bring colder temperatures, so let's see what the Columbia weather is going to be with Quinn. Quinn?
Thanks, Emily. While we won't be singing Rain, Rain, Go Away, it'll be here till Monday. Here in Columbia, we're looking at rains from Saturday all the way to Monday. Even in North Carolina, Tennessee, and Georgia, we're expecting showers all in the southeast region. Here for our five-day forecast, on Saturday, we'll be looking at rain with a high of 45 and a low of 36. Sunday, say about the same temperatures, rain again. So remember to bring out those rain boots and have your umbrellas on hand. Monday, still the same. The high of 39, low of 30, and Tuesday, those showers should be out of here. Partly cloudy temperatures, high of 50, low of 29, and same with Wednesday, high of 49 and a low of 34. That's all I have for your weather. Sending things back to you, Emily.
Thanks, Quinn. Students at USC can now donate unused meal swipes. The university recognized many meal swipes were going to waste by the end of the semester, and a new initiative allows students to donate those unused meal swipes to other students who may need them. And now we send it over to Antonio Stinson with sports.
Thanks, Emily. The Gamecock women's soccer team finishes the season ranked number 17 in the United Coaches poll. They peaked at number 5 in the poll this season and stayed within the top 25 all season. This marks the 37th consecutive week of being in the top 25, which is the longest streak in program history. And now to the gridiron, where a couple of newcomers are making a splash. Two Gamecock freshmen have been named to the All-SEC freshman team. South Carolina freshman offensive lineman Dylan Wanham started each of the last five games of the season, which made him the first freshman offensive lineman to start since Mike Matulis in 2011. The other freshman is J.C. Horn, a defensive back that was a starter from day one and ranked fifth among SEC freshmen with 3.9 tackles per game. And Gamecock fans, you can see these two freshmen and the rest of the team in action one more time this season in the Belk Bowl against Virginia on December 29th at noon at the Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte, or you can just watch it on TV on ABC. Let's send it back to Emily.
Thanks, Antonio. That's all the time we have for you today. Thanks so much for following us at Carolina News this fall. Make sure to tune in next semester for new stories and a whole new team. Have a great rest of your day and happy holidays.